the piping plover is the highest profile endangered species in the Great Lakes region. It's found in the coastal ecosystem in the Great Lakes. If the plover is being protected, there are other elements of the Great Lakes that are also being protected. So less chance of development or use in a way that's not really compatible with the health of the ecosystem.
The piping plover facility has been here for over 30 years. And part of our core mission has always been conservation. And they need protection because where they build their nests are along these gravelly shores, and they sort of blend in with the shoreline. So they're really subject to disturbance. So we see people's dogs and just human activity disturb these birds. Our teams, they rush out all across the Midwest, and they go and they collect these eggs that have been abandoned, and they bring them back to our field station. And then we have zookeepers that hatch these little tiny birds from these eggs, and then they introduce them to how to be a bird in the wild. And we have, I think, something around a 30% success rate with these birds coming back to their home grounds. And you might be like, ooh, 30%, it doesn't sound like so much. But in fact, it's exactly the same percentage as if they were fledging in the wild. So we have 88 nesting pairs, and that's really exciting for the program and for the biological station.
The Great Lakes, to a large extent, being protected because of the presence of piping plovers, because of their legal status. The biostation is so perfect for the plover work, because when I first started, they were only found in the state of Michigan on two of the Great Lakes, and now we have birds nesting in other states. And the number of pairs have increased from Michigan now to Wisconsin, Illinois, and Ohio, Pennsylvania, and New York. It shows an increase in distribution. In any given year, we now have literally hundreds of people around the Great Lakes region who are volunteering. They're very motivated and are contributing not only to plover recovery and conservation, but to other related areas. The Detroit Zoo learned about what we were doing and said, you know, this is something we'd be very interested in, and we're wondering if we could partner up with you. And I thought, oh, this is great, because raising young plovers is a full-time job, and we were busy with research. So Detroit Zoo became involved, and we now have a captive rearing center. We have very good success, very close to the wild birds in terms of survival and return and nesting. As the numbers increase, more and more people are learning about plovers and being interested in them, not simply because they are cute, a lot of people say, because they represent an area that people want to visit in the Great Lakes.